Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. Today in the 13 WBTC plus 1 time frame, it has been decided what the next phase of the Siege of Fenris will be. It will be Dictatus Clexus, where the Clexus Assassin will be mentioned. Here he is, Iota. A monocycle card for 21 cost and 83 wounds, quite strong, quite a strong unit in my opinion. In the lore, the assassin is used as a hunter of other assassins, other psychers, traitors, and a chaos spawn. And he is a quite rare one in the lore, and so it will be the final member of the assassin's troop. He will debuff opponent's cycle on ranged and melee attacks, and as a trait it has fear. Perhaps you also have faced against him in the previous Tyranid versus Servants of the Emperor campaign. I actually faced against this card a few times. It was actually quite easy to take it down when you have the card advantage and strength to do so. In my opinion, this card will go and mesh really well with the Greyfax 4. Inquisitor Greyfax generally uses psychers in his deck, and in order to get this card quite fast and at the highest amount, what does your deck requires to have? It requires elites. One of the lovely things to get this card, each elite provides you 25% boost instead of 20, so that's actually quite lovely. And if you actually manage to get all this 7200 points, you will able to get 6, 8 and 10 copies of Clexus, and if you manage to get 2 more from the RNG, you actually will be able to make it to level 4, which is quite nice. And in my opinion, then you will reach fear trait 2, meaning you will debuff the opposing card for 40%, which will be quite strong in Greyfax's deck. He is also quite cheap, so it will also not be detrimental to the Greyfax's special rule. Let me increase the sound a little bit. So, what kind of deck have I come up with to do that? As you can see, it's quite a small deck. Why? I actually written down the all the cards that can has the elite keyword. For ranged, the cards that can be used are around 8. For Psyker is only 4, and for melee is actually 3, 6, 9 and 11. Oh, Discord message. 11. Okay. So I believe, in my opinion, to get a Psyker elite deck, it would be the most fun to have a Psyker elite deck yourself. Unfortunately, there are no elite warlords in the Servants of the Emperor. Perhaps there are no elite warlords at all in the game, if it's a keyword of the tabletop RPG as well, in my opinion. I am not really familiar with how the keywords attach to the cards, so if you were to know how it works, I would love you to educate me. This is the deck that I am going to use. It has 3 psychers and also Inquisitor Greyfax herself, making it a 4 psyker team. I haven't added any healers or like Rejuvenate or the Inspiring Presence card like Commissar Çelik. Why? Because this psyker Horsul has a psychic link, and thus inclusion of any other non-psychers are actually detrimental to him. And with this, one of the lovely thing is that I don't have the 199 all points unlocked. However, I actually get to have for the first time a maximum efficiency for the Greyfax, and I am quite happy with it. Why? I have more than 125, so 125 free points are available. What does it translate into? As you can see here, 125 used unused deck points will make 25 times 3% buff, meaning each of our cards will actually have 75% boost to their attacks and wounds as well, and a level 3 Grayfax. I think this will be quite a strong addition. So I don't have much gold left, unfortunately, but most importantly, let me go upgrade my cards. Here this card is also used in the Grayfax as well. Also, let me mention what kind of decks that you generally face against Grayfax. It's a quite popular deck. Most likely you yourself have also encountered many Grayfaxes, but in my opinion, Psychic Grayfax, Psyker Grayfax is the one that is being used the most. Navigator and the Inquisitor, who has Psionic Blasts, are actually quite popular cards that are used in them. For Psionic Blasts are good against Shredding Shields by also dealing damage to all three cards of your opponents, killing those who are at a really low level and directing your whole attack to another card for lovely and strong plays for you. Let me go ahead and increase whole soul attack. Its attack will only be increased for just plus 3 attacks, but with the 75% of the Grayfax's buff, the buff will actually be stronger than it appears. So let me upgrade the Primaris Psyker just a little bit. I believe the next one will be 75. Yep, the connection is a little bit problematic. It's 70. The next one will most likely how much, either 120 or 100, it wouldn't be good enough. So that's quite sad here, but regardless, perhaps should I upgrade him? No, not really. I am going to upgrade Primaris Psyker one more time. Yeah, unfortunately we are 8 gold short. That's quite sad. So let's go ahead and upgrade also one more time. Increase its HP quite a little bit. With the 75%, I believe it will hit around 80 or 90-ish as well. Unfortunately, neither of our troops have actually reached the trade 2, which is unfortunate. I am also really at low gold right now. Regardless, let's go ahead and see 125 empty points with a pure elite Psyker deck for the Inquisitor Grayfax is good enough to collect the newest Kalidox Assassin or not. Also, this deck will give you 60% additional points to collect the card in the next the campaign second stage 2 days later. Unfortunately, even though this is quite thematically aligned with the Kalidox Assassin for being an elite and an Psyker, I don't think an additional 60% should be good enough to be used to get him, collect him quite fast. For we will only have 2 days, 2 days of time. So I'm actually going to make a ranged video and a melee video to go alongside. For ranged, I am going to use Commissar Yarik, and for melee, I am going to use Canoness Viridian to add some change and refresh refreshment to you. We are against a Skull Taker. It's 10,053 trophies. This should be interesting. Why they are using Psychic, I don't know. Perhaps to make a one final attack with Skull Taker. But in my opinion, also utilizing the Skull Taking ability, the Locus of Decapitation on your own troops are actually quite strong as well. Unfortunately, due to the fact that my troops are at low levels, as you can see, they are no match against my opponent's far more stronger troops. That's quite sad. So as you can see here, we have released Psychic, but their own Psychic are actually higher than ours. So if I were to go with my own Psychic, I will actually receive the higher damage than them, which is quite sad. So I am going to leave the Psychic to retaliate against my opponent, while actually damaging the opponent with my own. range than melee attacks. Actually, at the cost of receiving just a 74 damage to my Greyfax, I can take down two of their bodyguards. Let's go ahead and see what the 75% boost does to Greyfax. And as you can see, we actually have 300 wounds for us and a really high damage on our own. The Skull Taker has only 130 damage, so as you can see here, we can actually take down two of them. And I believe I'm going to take this approach. Yeah, that's quite unfortunate that the Lord of Change will actually going to take down our Holdus here. Holdus, sorry. Yeah, and our they are going to concentrate their attack on us. But another good thing is their attacks don't actually synergize well with one another. And as you can see here, our Primaris Psyker will actually have a lovely retaliation attack alongside the Greyfax. And I believe our own ranged attack will wrap up the game. As you can see, we can also kill them with our own psychic attack. And we can also kill them with our own melee attack. A quite flexible deck for just 3 cards, even though the opposition was relatively weak for us. Of course, my own Skull Taker was around level 7, but of course, their Lord of Change was around level 2. Our own cards are actually relatively low in levels as well. So, I actually win this win in all 3 attack types, and I believe it's a quite good YouTube video title as well. A deck that can get you the win with all 3 types of attacks. Once again, advertising this deck as the 60% additional bonus point collecting for the Kaleidos Assassin. I hope you like this deck. I haven't really played Greyfaxes, as I said before. I am still waiting to collect 199 points. Let's go ahead and see what does the Greyfax has got for us. A 75 gold, which I was actually quite short on gold, so that's a lovely addition. We thank Greyfax and her elite psychers for this lovely presence. And yeah, that's about it. I am at 97 gold and this is my deck. Only 3 psychers, which are all elite. Let me go ahead and show you. Psyker and Elite. Holsul. Cadian Psyker and Elite here. And finally your own Navigator. Psyker and Elite. Unfortunately Greyfax isn't. Though let me quickly show you again. He's not Elite. She is not Elite. But this will get you 60% boost in the upcoming event second phase 2 days later. To get you your own Kadius Assassin, the new Assassin's copies. Perhaps if he or she is an elite of its own, we can include that card in our deck as well. And with that we will be able to get 80%. Let me go ahead and quickly check that card whether if it's elite. Or not, yeah, that's an elite and only for 21 cost. Inclusion of this card will actually be quite nice for us. And from 126, I would go back to 105, meaning how to say divided by 5. No, yeah, 21. So a 63% boost over 75% boost will be achieved. And in my opinion, inclusion of more than 3 cards, like 4 or 5 cards in a Greyfax deck is really strong. So that way an 8% elite psyker deck of Inquisitor Greyfax would get you a lot of copies of the new Kaleidos Assassin. I hope this episode has entertained you and I hope you get all the 10 copies of the Kaleidos Assassin 2 days later in the campaign of Siege of Fenris. Until that time, I would like you to take good care of yourselves while also not missing my 2 other episodes of Elite Ranged and Elite Melee cards. Take good care of yourselves.